Today we're going to be making a tarte à la tomate, a beautiful tomato tart from Provence with beautiful, simple ingredients that bring back so many memories for me from my time in the south of France when I was doing my cooking apprenticeship and met my wonderful husband. For my tomato tart, I use a pâte brisée made with flour, unsalted butter, egg yolk, salt, and some ice water. To start, we use our flour and we continue with our cold unsalted butter. And we just want to mix it together until they're well combined and not too overworked, because you want it to be a nice flaky dough. And once you have a good even consistency with the butter and the flour, you can then add your egg yolk. We add a little salt. And our ice water. Be careful not to overwork the dough. You just want to roll it in a ball and then wrap it up and refrigerate for approximately 1 hour. The ingredients for my tomato tart are Dijon mustard, Niçoise olives, fresh tomatoes, some red onion, some Gruyère cheese, salt, pepper, and some fresh basil. We'll use a typical tart pan with a removable bottom lined with some parchment paper.
Hi, madame. What are you cooking?
Oh, I'm cooking this delicious tomato tarte à la Provençale. With these simple ingredients, it's very easy to make and it's begging to be baked.
Honey, I understand that you've been called a dancing chef.
Yes, I've been called the dancing chef. Cooking is my daily passion, but dancing has been a part of my life for a very long time. But honey, you know that.
Yes.
We are going to use a generous amount of Dijon mustard layered on the bottom, some Gruyère cheese, the sliced tomatoes, some Niçoise olives, the red onion, some salt and pepper, and a drizzle of extra virgin olive oil. Some fresh basil. Es mejor que te vayas, que estás muy mal parado. Ahora mismo. Tú querías embarcarme y quedaste tú mismo embarcado.
Now I really feel like dancing. Honey, can you wash the tart?
Si lo que quiero es que te vayas a pa' diablo pa' otro lado.
Ahora mismo.
We're just going to finish off with a little bit of fresh basil on top. Rip it apart, put it on, and it's ready to serve.
Mmm,
so delicious.